Let us study the chart showing different enzymes and digestive juices and their functions. Here is the table chart here. What are the enzymes are present in our body, how they are helpful usually while digestion. Usually in the morning we will just take a breakfast and the lunch and then snacks and dinner. So these all food items, how they will be balanced in our body, how they are digesting day by day. So grandmothers and grandfathers will digest it late. And for youngers like you, will digest very faster. And after the adult getting adult stage, it also digest. That means the food will be digested very fast. So every time we will say digestion, digestion, digestion. So what is back of this digestion method? Today we will discuss. So here you can see table one in your textbook. Some enzymes and juices of the gut. Gut means here alimentary canal. Understood? So first one, if we discuss, ptyalin is there. So ptyalin is important here. Which is a table column is there, first you need to remember here serial number is there, enzyme secreted by which part of our body will be secreted and that will secrete into which part. So it is secreted here and released into which part, that is the secreted into one. And this secretion part, what it has, that is the digestive juice, and what is the use of that and what products are produced here, these are clearly given. So that means here enzyme will be there, it is secreted by one organ and that organ will secrete to another organ to help, and what is present in that enzyme is digestive juice and it will act on one chemical to produce one chemical. So this all we will discuss now. So if this is completed, then you are done with your enzyme chart. Why? Because in SSE you will be getting questions directly from this table chart, or sometimes 8 cannot be given, 5 will be asked here. You need to remember any of the all 8 and you need to write for any 5. And here if you see, first one it is ptyalin is there. Ptyalin is otherwise called a salivary enzyme. So it is secreted by salivary glands. Salivary glands we discussed in last year 9th class, you will be having about salivary glands here. 3 types of salivary glands are there, under our tongue and beside our jaw and near our ear. So 3 pairs are there. And where it is secreted into, it is secreted into buccal cavity. Buccal cavity means here into the mouth, and after that it consists of a digestive juice called as saliva. So usually we will call saliva. So that is what here saliva is a digestive juice, and it will act on carbohydrates. Carbohydrates means here we will eat rice, chapati, or otherwise you will take juices, or otherwise you will take sweets. These all consists of carbohydrates. So that foods will be digested by saliva, and how they will transfer. That means saliva will transfer carbohydrate to turn into dextrins and maltose. So this you need to remember. And next one, dextrins and maltose will be very very easy to digest in our body. Understood? So these are the very simpler forms in our body, and they will digest very fastly. Next one here, pepsin is there. Pepsin, it is secreted by stomach only. So our stomach only will produce this pepsin, and then it will release into the stomach again. So what is the juice present in it? Juice is digestive juice, and it will act on proteins. It will convert the proteins into peptones directly. Chart you need to remember in your intermediate higher standard, then these all will be having little changes. Understood? So as of now, this much is enough for your 10th class. Next one, third. So you will eat chicken and mutton here. So these proteins will digest into peptones very fast. It will digest in our body. Understood? So next one, it is bile, and you need to remember this is the only one enzyme substance which does not have any enzyme. No any enzyme is present here. Like here one enzyme is there, amylase. What is an enzyme? Any chemical which ends with a ase word, it is called as an enzyme in biology and in chemistry also. So this does not have any enzyme. So it is released, it is secreted by liver. And it is secreted into duodenum. Duodenum is a continuation part between stomach and small intestine. In fact, in Greek language, duodenum means 12. So that means here 12 centimeters will be there, this organ. That's why in Greek it is called as duodenum. Understood? So from that duodenum, that means liver produces that one, and then it releases into the liver. And after that, it releases into the duodenum. Then its digestive juice is called as bile juice. And it will act on what? Fats. Daily we will intake oil in our curries, ghee in our curries, if you eat pizzas, cheese and butter. So these fat substances usually will be digested by liver by production of bile juice. So what will happen here? Yeah, that process is called that means the breakdown of fats into smaller oil globules is called as emulsification. This many times it has been asked in SSC examination for one mark. What is emulsification? Emulsification means breakdowning of large fats. The spelling is wrong. You correct it in your textbook. Large fats into, that is not spelling is wrong. Space has been not given here. Here space must be given. So large fats into small oil globules. So these with the help of this bile juice, oils are converted into small oil globules. This process is called as emulsification. Next one here, amylase. Amylase is an enzyme which is secreted by pancreas and also released by duodenum. Four are released into duodenum, you need to remember. And this will have a digestive juice called as pancreatic juice. And it can act on carbohydrates, and then carbohydrates turn into maltose. That means in your mouth, if you are not chewing properly, then in stomach anyhow, that will be digested with the help of same enzyme produced by pancreas. Next one, fifth one, trypsin is there. Trypsin is secreted by pancreas and that will release into duodenum. Then after that, its digestive juice is called as pancreatic juice. Wherever pancreas secretes the juice is called as pancreatic juice. And it will act on proteins, and then proteins will turn into peptones. Next one here, lipase is there. Most important here. Whatever fats, this lipase is produced by pancreas, that means in even in intestinal wall also, that will release into the duodenum. And after that, this pancreatic, that means this consists of pancreatic juice and intestinal juice. As it is produced from pancreas, it is called as pancreatic juice. It is produced from intestinal wall, it is called as intestinal juice. And then where it will act? It will act on fats. Again, biryani, you will eat pizzas, you will eat burgers, you will eat these all fats. Will be digested into fatty acids and glycerols. Thereby, it will very fastly digest in our body. Last, second one, peptides. Peptides is secreted by small intestine, and it will secrete into the small intestine. Same like the pepsin, how it will secrete and release into the stomach. Same here, peptidases and peptidases will be secreted by small intestine and released into the small intestine. And what is the juice here? Intestinal juice, and acts on peptides. Then peptides will change into amino acids. These are the very smallest protein molecules here. Amino acids are the very smallest protein molecules. Thereby, it will help in our body development. That means whenever you are getting injuries or new cells are producing, new blood cells are producing, then these peptidases are most important. Why? Because whatever protein we are taking, that will be digested into amino acids. Last one, it is sucrose. Sucrose will have an enzyme called as sucrase. Here not given, you need to remember. Sucrase, AAC, here AAC. And it is secreted by small intestine and secreted into the smallest intestine. That means it produces there only, and it releases into that region only. And it is called as intestinal juice. As I said already, intestinal wall, whatever it produces, it is called as intestinal juice. Here also intestinal, small intestine is produced, then it is called as intestinal juice. Then it will act on sucrose, cane sugar. Usually sugar cane, we will say usually, so that is the sugar present in the sugar cane, it is called as sucrose, and then it will convert into glucose. That's why, have you seen glucon D is a usually in summer we will see glucon D, drink a glucon D, then it helps from the sun. A sun diagram will be there, and it will have eyes, nose with a straw on one person's head. It will be sucking that all nutrients from our body, minerals from our body. So this is what here, same thing here, glucose is the very easiest form of digestion and mixing in our body. Ready energy will be given by glucose. That means these company members will give directly glucose digested form. But here, this is the last enzyme, sucrose is the enzyme which will digest sucrose to sucrase. Here sucrase, you need to write up. This is not enzyme, this is A, this is a mistake here. Sucrase is the enzyme which will convert this sucrose to glucose. So you need to remember that here, total in our body, enzymes play very important role. So these enzymes are most important, starting from our mouth it is important, and in stomach it is important, then intestine, that may, or otherwise duodenum, and after that a small intestine. In large intestine, we cannot find anything. These are most important here, along with the liver. In liver, one juice is there, bile juice, which does not have any enzyme. So, you need to run it separately. Then, we will discuss about the flow chart of a digestive system. Before going to that digestive system here, so usually we will discuss a little part of that. I'm dropping here. Before going to that, we need to have some knowledge on that, and this topic is important. Usually for 2 marks in your exam will be asked. Usually transport of products will be there. So these transport of products of digestion from intestine to blood will have a very diversified form here. That means whatever we take food into our body in the stomach, that will digest and enter into the blood. And then what will happen here, the digestion of blood will, that means the food materials will be released into the blood. And this, that means the transport of products of digestion into the blood from intestine, from intestinal wall or intestine, is called as absorption. This is 1 mark answer. Remember that. I am explaining again here. Transport of products from of digestion from intestine, that means from stomach to intestine and intestine to blood through the wall of the small intestine is called as absorption. Whatever we eat food, that enters from stomach and stomach to intestine, intestine to blood, and this process is called as an absorption of food. So the next one, internally in the intestine there are nearly finger like projections are there in a small intestine. If you see with a microscope or without microscope, we can see small finger like projections will be there here. If this is the intestinal wall here, so very finger like projections will be there. We will learn this in a 7th chapter, and how here introduction is there. So these finger like projections are called as microvilli. So this villi will increase the absorption area. So absorption area is increased. If absorption area is increased, then digestion increases. And again, blood supply of this villi will be very very fast, and lymph vessels also are present here. This all terminologies are given in the first chapter for the next coming classes, to for next coming chapters to understand very easily. Next one, the products of digestion is there here. So first products of digestion are absorbed first into the villi form, and from here the blood vessels and lymph vessels will be absorbed. After that, what will happen? Maximum absorption of food will happen in small intestine. So this is a choose the correct answer in your SSC. Where is maximum absorption of food will be occurring? Small intestine. Why? Because it is a coiled structure which is present under the stomach. So it will take a large time to digest. After that, it consists of a large intestine, small intestine to large intestine. Here, most of the water is absorbed here. That means very surprising here, food is absorbed in a small intestine and water is absorbed in the large intestine. If you remember, and this material is then expelled to. That means after the stomach, small intestine, and large intestine, then this material is again pushed back into the next part. It is called as anus. So what is the here this material which is the last part of the alimentary canal. Alimentary canal means here our digestive system. Alimentary canal or gut, it is called as a digestive system, and this is the last part of our body. And the food is passed, this passage of undigested material from the body by the way of anus is called as defecation. That means here the food which is thrown out from our body through the anus is called as defecation. And food that passes out the anus still contains considerable amount of proteins, fats, carbohydrates, roughages or fibers of that means even a digested food in our body in the anus, it consists of carbohydrates, proteins, lipids and minerals, and some kind of carbohydrates will be present. If necessary, from anus again it will be absorbed back to our body. Understood? So to understand this all, again 7th chapter is very clear for that. So here only basics are given in our textbook. Then we will move to the flow chart of human digestive system, how it will work. Here you can see, first we will take the food. Understood? So what will happen here, after taking the food, that food transfer into the mouth. then we will start the mouth is present in buccal cavity. Understood? So we will just take sweets or otherwise juices, anything. That means we will open the mouth, then a cavity is formed here. Whenever you open the mouth, cavity is formed. That is called as buccal cavity. And then the food will reaches into the pharynx. So here many students will confuse you. So pharynx, larynx. Pharynx is called as food pipe. Larynx is called as air pipe. So larynx we will discuss in second chapter. Pharynx we will are discussing in this chapter. So pharynx is continued by the another part called as esophagus. So esophagus is near the throat region. So if this is the face here, this is so this region is the esophagus. So esophagus, after the esophagus, the stomach is divided into three parts here. So what are the three parts here? Cardiac stomach, pyloric stomach, and fundic stomach. Here part is not given, even in your textbook also. So this is the important flow chart here, you need to remember. So after, stomach is divided into three types: cardiac stomach, fundic stomach, and pyloric stomach. After that, a 12 centimeter organ is there, duodenum. So in duodenum, what will happen here? Two juices will be added from liver and pancreas. From pancreas, pancreatic juice is added to the duodenum, and from liver, bile juice is added to the duodenum. From there, the food along with these two juices will be mixed and enters into the small intestine. There in small intestine, nearly 3 to 5 hours, if it is a mild food, or sometimes 24 hours, food will be digested. Then it will send into the large intestine. After that large intestine, a water is present in the large intestine, means water is absorbed. The next one, it will send into the rectum. Rectum, in case of Greek language, it is called as pial. That means pial's necklace you will just wear for your neck. So that is the meaning of that. Then nectum. Then after that, from nectum to anus, food is passed. Then here, you know very well what we will do early morning. Understood? So just sit on the lavatory board, and then you will complete your work. So from which part it will be coming outside or defecated outside from our body, it will be defecated from a part called as anus. Next one, very health aspects we need to discuss here. Why? Because human alimentary canal usually functions very good in considering many occasions. Whatever foods you take here, it will be making a good. And again, sometimes if you won't take a good food also, we will fall into sick. And vomiting is the body's method of ridding of unwanted and harmful substances from our stomach. So every time whenever you eat a very unbalanced food here, vomiting will be getting. So what is that here? That is a method of getting or throwing out all unwanted or harmful substances from the stomach. And here also peristaltic movement, what we discussed in the last class, is the movement of food from one region to another region by continuous movement of the side walls. Contractional relaxation of the walls will make the food to go from one place to another place. So here the same explanation will be there in case of vomiting. And there are many causes of vomiting are there. So but most common thing is that having more amount of fat, more oily food if you are taking, means vomiting will be getting. Why? Because more oil is indigestible, and again it is very very poisonous. Understood? So when we have a greenish vomit, usually called as a bilious. So this one more question or choose the answer will be there here. So what is that here? Bilious or liverish? Bilious or liverish. At that time we get a green color vomiting. You need to understand that whenever you are getting green color vomiting, we are getting bilious or liverish. Sometimes it also leads to jaundice disease. And next, what is the thing here? We will be having a very bitter taste, like bitter gourd if you take, so that taste will be having. And again, it also affects in not eating anything. We cannot eat anything, and then what will happen? The liver is unable to digest the fat. Thereby, what will happen? We will also get nausea, unable to do any work. Nausea is the thing, unable to do any work. So what we need to do here, some healthy aspects are there here. Indigestion is generally caused by many criteria here. So sometimes food is not digested, we will make. And there is a difficulty in digesting food. So healthy people can usually avoid problems. These problems related to digestion. In how many ways here? 5 ways are there. Understood? So if you see here, these 5 ways, what are the things here? Having simple and well-balanced meals. That means our meals plate must be very very simple. That means vegetables must be there, fruits must be there, and rice must be there, or chapati must be there. So carbohydrates, minerals or otherwise vitamins, proteins, and again here also fruits. So it's very simple, we need to put our meals plate. The next one here, eating food in a leisurely manner. Some people will eat only within 1 minute. So 1 minute if you are eating means here, that is not at all a eating process. You are just eating like a very fasterly to complete your work. Understood? Very leisurely, into at least 15 minutes you need to eat the food. So why 15 minutes here? How much chewing if you do with the help of your teeth and mouth, then that much good your digestion rate will be there. Understood? For example, for a week you just follow this thing, you will find many advantages in your body. Next, third one, thoroughly masticating the food. That is what I said here. 15 minutes you need to chew your food, then it will be digested very fast. And avoiding taking violent exercises soon after eating the food. So after eating the food, you must not go to the steps or down the steps, up the steps. You must not play anything. Why? Because your stomach will be in a resting stage to accumulate all the food materials whatever you have eaten. Last but not the least here, drinking plenty of water and having regular bowel movements. So good amount of water if you take means the food also will be freely flowing in your body. Thereby it will also help in digestion. And again, a more serious form of indigestion is caused by stomach and duodenal ulcers. Usually if you are not indigestion will be getting means ulcers and indigestion problems will be getting. Thereby what will happen here, most people will be affecting due to this indigestion effects only. But we need to worry and we need to hurry to go to the doctor. Then this ulcers also, usually ulcers will also make people to be very very irritating phenomenon. Why? Because due to this busy schedule nowadays here, everyone will have hurry eating of meals, and due to excess of eating here, we are not giving sufficient rest also. So fastly eating and excessively eating and no rest will cause ulcers, then tensions will be there. So that's how what we need to make here, we need to follow this 5 methods here. First thing, whatever you follow or not, you need to eat the food 15 minutes in 15 minutes very slowly. You need to 15 minutes we will get time everywhere, even in school also 45 minutes break time will be given. So 15 minutes if you go for washing your hands before the food and 15 minutes after the food, then in the middle 15 minutes is there, you can eat that. So now we will take if that food is not taken properly, what are the diseases we will get, we will see. First one, it is kwashiorkor. So here you can see this picture, how the people are not eating properly and how the diseases are getting, you can see here. So what is that here? We know that food is the main source of food to maintain biological processes in a perfect manner. But our diet should be also a balanced one, which contains a proper amount of carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, mineral salts and fats. And 2/3 of world's population, if you see, is affected by food related issues. So 2/3 of population, for example 7 billion is there means here, at least 3 to 4 billion people are affected with food related issues only. There, whether it is intake of excess food or not intaking of the excess food. And usually some of them are suffering from consuming high calorie food, high amount of food. Why? Because everyone will eat at a time. So most of them are facing many problems due to the lack of balanced diet. It is important to discuss this food related issue. First thing, and again, if you see, eating of food that does not have one or more than nutrients in the required amount of our plate. For example, in our plate, carbohydrates are there, proteins are there, and water is there, fiber is there, but fiber is there. But fats are not there, and again here vitamins are not there. So anything if you are not including in our meals plate, then it will lead to diseases here. So that we need to have some awareness here. So what is first thing if we make here? Eating of food that does not have one or more than one nutrients that is required for our food is called as malnutrition. Mal in Greek language, bad. That means here one or more than one nutrients are not there in our meals plate means, then it is called as malnutrition. So due to malnutrition, what will happen? Diseases will be getting. So first disease, if you see, you can see here, kwashiorkor. Generally, three types of malnutrition diseases are there. First one, it is protein malnutrition. Second one, it is calorie malnutrition. Third one, it is protein and calorie malnutrition. So protein separately, calorie separately, protein and calorie combined malnutrition. Now we will discuss about these types of nutrition here. So what is that nutrition type here? First one, it is kwashiorkor. This is due to protein deficiency. That means proteins they are not taking, pulses they are not taking, dals or dals, that means pulses are otherwise called as dals. And after that, meat, whether it is chicken or otherwise fish or prawns or any egg, so they are not taking this protein. And then this will, without taking protein, what will happen here? If you see clearly, the bones will become very very swollen. They will swell, swollen region will be there, bones will be swelling, that means increasing. And due to accumulation of water, why this will increase here? It will increase due to increase of water in this intercellular spaces are present in the bone. And very poor muscle development. If you see here, a muscle is developed high, and this area muscle is developed very very poor. And next, legs also will be very very swollen. And face, if you see, means here fluffy face means here increased face, and which is very difficult to eat. Usually this will occur in case of children, malnutrition. And loose motions is a common thing, loose motions, which is called as diarrhea. And other dry skin also will be there here, dry skin. So these are the things here. In your exam, 4 marks will be there for this topic here. What is that? It is occurred through protein, not taking protein, right amount of protein you are not taking is here, this disease will occur. So face will be fluffy face, bones will be having very very swollen, and proper improper development of muscles here. One region muscles are more, one region muscles are very less. And diarrhea will be occurring here, and bones will be swelling due to accumulation of water. Then after the legs also will swell, and diarrhea will be occurring, and dry skin also will be there. Next we'll see about marasmus. This is called as marasmus, and this will occur due to not taking proteins and again calories. That means here eggs we are not taking, or meat you are not taking, like fish and chicken, and pulses you are not taking, dal you are not taking, means you will get this one. Along with that, rice you are not taking properly, chapati you are not taking properly, and milk you are not taking properly. So due to these things here, you will get this marasmus disease. Then we will discuss what is this disease about. This is deficiency of both the proteins plus calories, that is for sure. And generally this will occur in an immediate, for a mother usually in 1 year, a son has born for that mother, and another year only in the second, that means 2020 son has born, and 2021 another son or another child or another daughter, son or daughter, or son or daughter has born. So within 1 year, in a gap, that means in 2020 and 2021, each year one son or one child has born to the mother, then the next child will get this kind of disease. That means alternatively, continuously, year by year, if a mother gets pregnancy, second child will get this marasmus. Understood? But don't think about if you are a second child in your family, you have got that. It is not like that. In very poor conditions, it will occur. Understood? This is a disclaimer part here. And next one here, repeated births. That means year by year, if any mother is making a pregnancies for a good child, then continuous childs will be getting the marasmus here. Then what we can make here? Very 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 lean development of muscles, very lean development of muscles, that means poor development of muscles you can see. And the skin also very very dry skin will be there, and loose motions will be there, that is called as diarrhea. And these are the symptoms of this disease. And the person will appear very very weak, and bones you can count also very easily. Next one, obesity, higher eating of thing. This is due to overeating and excess of calories intake. That means excess of calories, if you are taking more amount of rice, chocolates, sugar compounds, juices, or any pizzas, burgers, outside, everything, if you are eating, means you will be getting this condition again. Generally, this disease will occur where there is an immediate that means larger intake of foods. And again, this is a very biggest health hazard. Why biggest health hazard means here? Usually this will make in childhood diabetes. In childhood only you will be getting sugar disease, BP you will be getting, and it is harmful for your heart, and also it is harmful for your kidneys, and even if it is harmful for urine formation. So these are the problems will be there here. And these diseases are usually malnutrition diseases. There are some other diseases also there here, vitamin deficiency diseases. So vitamin deficiency diseases we can see in case of this chart. So vitamin deficiency diseases are usually vitamins are organic. Vitamins are organic substances. They are very micronutrients which are required in very very smallest. If you need food this much means vitamins are needed only this much. So very very smaller in mg's only, microgram, milligram or microgram, microgram. And actually vitamins are not synthesized in our body, but we need to eat from external source except vitamin D. So vitamin D is prepared in our body when we stand under sunlight after taking up little fat. And one is the diet and other is the bacteria present in the intestine that synthesizes and supplies vitamins to our body. There are two vitamins in our body which are need not to take from outside. One is vitamin D and one is another vitamin B12. So these two vitamins are produced in our body only, except this we need to make. Now we discuss about vitamin deficiency diseases here. So this complete chart you need to remember like that only. Why? Because it is most important for your exams here. How many things are there? Then these vitamins in a special class we just discussed. Understood? Why? Because this is most important, and in the next coming class I will discuss about these all things with a thing examples also.